So this is Sniper Elite 4, just got released today. I played the third Sniper Elite. Actually, I think that was the first Sniper Elite that I ever played. And I actually like that game. And I even like, studio also did the Zombie Army Trilogy, which is basically like a reskinned Sniper Elite game, and you're just fighting off hordes of zombies. It actually has a story mode. Hitler's trying to resurrect the dead to win the war, and you pick one of several soldiers to go on a mission to kill him and stop the zombie apocalypse. That game's pretty badass. But that's what actually got me into the Sniper Elite series. So this is the new release, and I'm going through the campaign. I don't remember the first, well, not the first, I don't remember the last game having a skill tree that you can edit. As you can see here, you can edit a skill tree. I'm going to do that right now. What is this? Would you like to play through the first time? No. What is that? What is first time guide? Hang on for a second. Play the first time guy. I don't even know what that is. So let's see what this is like. If you don't know about the Sniper Elite Trilogy, one of the selling points of the game in this series is that when you do, I'm gonna skip this if you don't mind. When you do
world at war.
Certain kills, like headshots, or not
we
even headshots.
The trap on Hitler's North Africa campaign.
The game chooses
but
when it
next?
Does this special feature, but when you get certain
Churchill
shots,
urged an allied invasion of Italy.
Camera follows the
call
it goes
the Mediterranean
into dramatic,
the soft underbelly of the crocodile.
Shot of the bullet coming out
the
of the
Americans
gun,
took some convincing.
Traveling great
but
distances.
Winston won
and
them
then,
over.
Right as it's about to impact the target,
General
it goes
Dwight
into like
D.
an X-ray view of the target.
Allied commander in chief is masterminding the entire Mediterranean
the
strategy.
Through whatever part of the body you're aiming,
me,
so it goes into the skull. You
I'm
see
headed
like
for
X-ray view of the skull,
a secluded
the bullet,
island
like,
to Italy
pierce
southwest.
The skull and shatter the bone, and the slug spins out the other side. It's pretty badass. It's graphic, but it's badass. So here we have it, Sniper Elite 4. I don't really pay too much attention to the story.
We've been losing ships in the area. British intelligence thinks the Luftwaffe's presence on San Salini might explain
so
why.
Like playing the game, so.
The Royal Navy dispatched a captured Italian
right
freighter,
the
Arcadia, to investigate.
So
she was equipped with the very latest radio interception equipment.
Was, really
the intelligence she got.
Alright, so let's go. So I barely remember the campaign of the last game, Sniper Elite 3, but I don't remember it being having like little side missions like this. Oh shit, there's a dude right there.
Thank you.
thing that this game does that I don't think the previous game did. Actually, no, the previous game didn't do this. Is when you do melee kills now, you also get the 3D view. All right, so boom, I'm going to show you this feature. Where the hell is dudes at? All right. So I'm going to mark this target. Supposed to be like two dudes up there. Man, that's gotta be like a pretty bad way to go. You spend all your military career training for combat and shit, and you get taken out by a falling cannon. Messed up. Alright, let's see. It's fully automatic. Recoil dampening, rate of fire range. Let's shoot slower, but you know what? Let's swap it.
Can't find anything else.
All right. See if I can get a X-ray kill.
Tower looks like a good vantage point.
Man, they're just exploring. I can't even tell if these are considered good graphics for the game. Oh shit. Damn, did he see me? Man, I can't even tell if these are like good graphics for PS4. I feel like these are not that good. But they're not bad. But they ain't that good. You know what I'm saying? Alright, bet. So I don't know if you could do this. I can't remember if you could tag enemies in the last game. But it's cool because once you tag them, then like once I zoom out, like they still, I can still track their positions, even through walls and shit, which is not realistic, but it's helpful. Oh, shit. All right. Oh. Oh, so you know, see that little icon right there? What I would do is, and I think that's what that's for. So say like I wanted to take a shot at one of these guys, but I didn't want anyone else to hear. What you could do technically is you could wait till that plane passes by, and you use the sound of that plane to match the shot of your weapon, so you can get a shot off without anybody else hearing. So most likely that plane is gonna come by again. It's gonna patrol through or whatever. It'll be on a pattern, and I think that
hey there,
that's how you.
You're on my target list.
Oh, I found a target, and that's how you take out these guys. You can mask your shots. Otherwise, you're gonna alert everybody down there, and then you end up in this tower. Even though it's an elevated position, tactically elevated positions are ideal. But even if you're in this elevated position, if you alert all these people, you're kind of stuck in this. So you don't want to be stuck up here when shit goes tits up. So the best way to do it is use the sound of the airplane to mask your gunshot, which I'm not going to do because I'm not patient. Actually, you know what? I should be patient because it's kind of what being a sniper is all about. Man, you hear stories about real snipers, and like when I was in the military, I was in the army. We had a scout platoon that, because I was a line medic, I was a combat medic attached to an infantry platoon, and we had a scout platoon with our unit, and you know, they had snipers too, and they would just talk about how they would just sit in a spot for hours or days
with the Orchidia center stage.
But you gotta be super patient. And sometimes you sit in a spot waiting on your target for all that time, and then you end up, you know, not doing anything. You end up changing your mind or canceling it, or, you know, your intel proves fruitless. That shit would piss me off. I'd be like, I'm shooting something. Fuck this. Alright, so I'm pretty sure there's a way for me to. So I'm supposed to kill all. I'm supposed to kill these high value targets, these HVT, right? So that one guy, I just him kill officers. So I'm pretty sure. God damn. Oh, I'm pretty sure there's a way for me to kill him without alerting anybody else, and possibly not even having to kill any of these other soldiers. There's three of them. So I'm gonna try and see if I could take this dude out. Let's see if I can take that dude out without alerting anybody else. But I need a distraction. Fuck. Damn. Alright, so let's see. Who is that? Let's see. Damn it. Alright. So I want to take this officer out. So, I think what I'm going to do is, I'm going to go ahead and try to take this shot. Man, this shit's going to be hard. He's so far away. I'm going to try to take this shot. I'm going to try to take this shot. Woo! Oh, shit. Did you see that? Dope. So, they're kind of on alert. See the in the map on the bottom left, those two yellow dots. They're like, yo, we heard something, but they don't know where it came from yet. So I'm good. So I just have to wait it out for a minute. But I got the first target. That shit was dope. Did you see it go through the back of his head? That's the cool part about that's the feature of this game. Oh shit, they're searching. But they don't know necessarily where I'm at. They on alert. Oh, they found his body. Oh, shit. Damn. Oh, they gave up. Search is over. All right, so I got to sneak. Oh, crap. See a question mark. Man, what are you searching for again, man? You already found the body. He's like, yo, somebody just blew his brains out. All right, so I'm gonna move now. Let's see if I can, there's a bunch of shit here. All right, so I'm gonna see if I can get closer to the next targets without being spotted. Shit. Damn. Silence pistol. Oh, I can silently kill that dude. That's what I was thinking. So one of the cool things about the Sniper Elite series, at least for the third one, the game before this one, you could play it in stereoscopic 3D. So if you had a 3D TV, you could play the game in 3D, which is cool because I have a 3D TV. Damn! Oh, damn, dog. Already? Oh, now I'm fucking playing when Damn! That shit sounded just fine. That was a mean headshot, boy. Who the fuck is that? Shit. Ooh, I shot him in the heart. I didn't really zoom in on that dude. Watch this. Next time he put his head up. Headshot. Oh man. Who doing that? Damn. Damn. Graphic and gory, but See, now the airplane flies away, so I could use that earlier to match the sound of That was dope. Still more dudes coming?
Guess I grabbed everything useful.
Damn, I ain't got no. What is this? Mine? I'm about to start. Yo, that bullet went through him and hit the other dude. That shit was tight. Man, suppressed ammo. Dog, I could have. You know what? I could have used suppressed ammo. I'm gonna restart this. I'm gonna restart it. I didn't even know I could do that. Skirts. Oh shit. Destroy cameras, clear checkpoint, kill Nazi officers by any means. Damn, dog. Wait. Okay. There's an officer down there. So, I'm gonna just circle around. Damn. Be still, motherfucker. I said, how many motherfuckers is it? What's down there? I don't want to be down. Oh, shit. Oh shit. Woo! Oh man. This gonna be an asshole. So I failed miserably. I tried to use the airplane flying over to mask the sound of my gunshot. But I missed the shot. So in this game, if you miss your target, oh shit.
Hunter!
Does he see me? Impossible to see me, dog. Come on, man. How did he see me? I'm in this shit. I should restart this shit. No, you know I'm not gonna restart. I'm probably like, don't restart this shit. Alright. So. Did it. Haha. Let's see about using suppressed ammo. 30 sound mass kills. Oh. 20 kills over 100 meters. Mastery skin. Hard shots. Alright. Let's use masked ammo. Let's see how we do with this. I was tight. I knocked that motherfucker off his feet. Oh shit. I shot that dude in his eye. Yo, I'm a bad man. That shit said eye shot. I shot that dude in his eye. Alright, let's reload.
Nothing else.
Hide the body. I'm throw this motherfucker off a cliff.
This will come in very useful.
Alright. It's always fun to do. Tight. your sound, man.
Okay.
All right, what we got? Shit. Some dudes out there. Man, they told me there's somebody up here the whole time. Shit. Alright, let's see what we got. Infantry. Who was talking about they missed their kids? What did I do yet? Ever since watching, so in case you don't know, for non, well, for people who are watching and don't know who I am, for my non-friends, my name is Darren. I am also known as the Disco Dork on the In the Mouth of Darkness podcast. In that podcast, we talk about all manner of geek shit. Mostly movies, though. Love movies. Comics and comic book movies. And we even have a castmate who specializes in stand-up comedy and other podcasts and things like that. So she'll do reviews and stuff like that. So yeah, check us out. We're on iTunes. If you search In the Mouth of Darkness, we're also on Podbean. Anyway, one of my most recent episodes, we have a discussion about Predator, John McTiernan's classic, and it's a pretty cool episode. A lot of fun to record that, and you should check it out. Anyway, so what we did in preparation for that episode was obviously we went back and revisited that movie, and for me. I don't know if it's because I'm a purist or just an overachiever. I decided to revisit all the Predator films. And so that includes the first one, the second one with Danny Glover, Predators with Adrian Brody, the one that came out like 2-3 years ago, Aliens vs. Predator, which sucks balls, and even Alien vs. Predator Requiem, which, while not perfect film by no means, it's not that bad. It ain't as bad as Alien vs. Predator. Anyway, revisiting those films makes me wish that there was a good Predator game. Yeah, because we don't have a good Predator game.
What do we have here?
Uh-oh, there's an officer around here. You know, I'm gonna blow this one up. Watch this. Oh, Damn. 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 His ass blown off. That was awesome. So I got what? Three officers left? Two officers left? That was pretty badass. Damn, that shit's still blowing up down there. That's what's up. Dude's freaking out. Let's, you can search, but you'll never find. Oh, they have no clue where I am. Watch this. Oh, shit. Shot his mouth off. Shot him in the mouth. Shot his jaw. Look at this. Yeah, man. He's scared. Damn, shot his jaw off too. That was amazing. Mass gunshot. Oh, man. Very satisfying, by the way, to get a successful long range masked kill. Alright, so let me see if I can get down there. Oh man, there was a guy right behind me. Of course, they search. What is this shit for? Oh shit. Wait, who saw me? Oh shit. Get out, motherfucker. Oh. Get this motherfucker. Bam! That's pretty dope, man. Why should you do that? I don't know what I did, but I just made it so that I can't use it for sound masking, which is whack. What we got? We got some dudes down there. Oh, shit. Man, back up. Sucks. I was really looking forward to using an engine to mask the shot of me killing those dudes. So anyway, yeah, a good Predator game. Last time I saw Predator in a video game, I think it was Mortal Kombat X. That's not exactly the type of Predator game I'm envisioning. I mean, I really want something where it could be like a third person. Yeah, it'd be like a third person. Okay. Yeah, that's right. There was like an Alien versus Predator. It was like a first person game, right? But I remember that not getting too good reviews. The fucking movie's way over there. So make it like a third person, shooter. You know, I just want Blaine and the minigun, old painless. I hear somebody, but I can't see him. Shooting people in the mouth. Shot him in the eye too. I'm gonna pop. Boom! That was pretty dope. Yeah, it was Predator films, man. First one is obviously the masterpiece. And as I said on the podcast, I enjoyed Predator 2 more than the first one. And I'm not saying Predator 2 is better than the first one. I'm just saying, this go around, I enjoyed it more than the first one. And I don't need to go down here. I'm gonna just fuck shit up. Yeah, so I enjoyed Predator 2 more than I enjoyed the first one. First one's a great film. And that's saying something, because the first one's a great film, and I enjoyed the first one.
No more to find
like,
here.
Man, that opening, like, from the opening sequence of Predator 2, it just clearly establishes that they're on that whole, you know, all right, this is the sequel. We gotta be bigger and badder and louder. It takes place in a few... in a futuristic 1997 in Los Angeles, when gang wars erupted and gang members and the Jamaican posse and the LA gangs, whatever, I can't remember what that's what they were called.
So
they're at war with the police in the streets of
the missile crazy. The fuel.
And then Danny Glover comes riding in his old box, police cars unmarked. And he's in full, like, action hero mode. Not like Roger Murtaugh with the weapon action. Come on, like, he's like Martin Riggs with the weapon. And you know what? I mean, it's off-putting at first, because you're not... What? It's off-putting because you're not used to seeing him in that capacity, but... like it works, like he sells it so good. He's a beast in Predator 2. And another thing we talked about in the episode was how, like, shit, how that's such a diverse cast. Oh shit, that just does not get old to me. Anyway, yeah, you got Danny Glover as the lead. You got Ruben Blades as his partner. Maria Cachito Alonso. Fuck. Got Maria Cachito Alonso. I used to love her. And then you got Ruben Blades. And then you got Bill Paxton. Bill Paxton, man. And he's probably like my least favorite. Because like, he just wasn't funny to me. Put your man down. Woo! Try to go help him. Man, that's a classic sniper trick. The guy. And then these people come out to him. Come on. Anyway.
Nothing else to find.
Yeah, Predator 2 is dope. There's way more action in it. shit, really, Arnold only dealt with the Predator, like, at the very end. And that was, like, maybe, in screen time total, that was, like, 3 to 5 minutes. And he really didn't do anything to the Predator except drop the freaking log on him. And then when they were standing face to face, that wasn't even, that was a lopsided match. He just got punched in the, face. And then he crawled to the booby trap. And, But in Predator 2, man, Danny Glover was, he had the confrontation in the frozen meat house, and then he had that shit on the rooftop, and then again in the back of the spaceship, and then there were just action sequences like prior to that, and in the first Predator, the encampment shootout action scene, and then when Blaine gets killed, they're just firing everywhere. They're blind firing, so they technically, I don't really count as an action scene, but they don't know what they're shooting at. Nothing's shooting back. They didn't really hit them. They hit them, but they didn't really do any damage. And then, somebody would be up there, yep. And then, towards the end, shit, Predator 2. You got the opening, and then you got that the part in the penthouse when the Jamaicans fucking voodoo magic man. You got that part, and then let's see, and then you got the train, which is oh, that's where I was earlier. You get the train sequence, which is outstanding. And that was really cool because they have, at that point in Los Angeles in 1997, apparently, like, as open carry, everybody's got, well, not open carry, it's concealed, I guess, because everybody on the train is carrying. So when they show that the Predator's on the train and the people are trying to stop the mugging on the train and everybody pulls out their piece, you're like, oh shit. Predator gets in there, all these people come down, but they got a gun. And, you know, it's established that the Predator only kills people who have a weapon. Which, here's my issue with Aliens vs. Predator, well, one of my issues, is that there were several instances where he was killing people that weren't armed. Maybe once or twice, but still, that's once or twice too many. It's against the rules, you don't do that. Oh shit. Some new suppressed ammo on this dude. See me, go ahead, dog. What am I about to say? That's scary. He's about to go over there and see his boy. Oh shit. Oh shit. Stop being nosy. Picking them off, and you're in an incline position, they're in an elevated position, and you're still taking them out. You always got a tactical advantage from an elevated position, but you don't take advantage of that tactical advantage. It's pointless. It means nothing. technically, I could just shoot that guy. Because ain't nobody else around to even hear the shot. In his neck. Open world game, like an open world map, but it's like I feel like it lacks focus because it's giving me the option to just go anywhere and do things in a non-linear fashion. So it's kind of, doesn't feel focused to me. I guess to the point where I'm forgetting like what I'm supposed to do. The main objective. Is it just kill those three dudes and like that's it? But how is that a progressive story? So I don't know. I'm torn like when games do that. When they'll have open world gameplay, so you can choose like how you want to approach it. But it's a thin line because every Grand Theft Auto game. I've only beat one Grand Theft Auto. That was Grand Theft Auto 5. And that was difficult to stay on track and to complete like all the missions and not get distracted by the different side quests and shit. There's somebody walking up here. Oh, shit. Oh, he'll be alright. Yeah, Grand Theft Auto 5 is like the only one that... Because I start following the story, and then on my way to a story objective, like a bunch of side quests will pop up, and I'll do them. And those side quests take so long. Especially if you do multiple ones that by the time you finish the side quest, you go, okay, where was I in this story? Where was I in there? Oh, shit. All right, I wonder where we get the suppressed ammo from. Damn. I shot him in the eye from the side. I don't know how I did that, but dope.
Plot thickens.
Damn.
Final curve.
That was tight. Alright. Shit. Oh shit. Sorry, dude. They know.
Do read.
Man, so do I bother with this silence now? Come on, get down, dude. What the fuck, man? Poor game design, man. Damn. Yes. That was dope.
Grabbed all I can.
Oh shit, these motherfuckers are right behind me.
Kessler seems to be key to all this.
Watch me get this guy. Watch me get this guy. Woo-hoo. Alright, there's a blue thing on the map over here. I don't know what it is, but we're about to find out. See where we're at. So I gotta go here and then come back here. Damn! Outskirts. Right. Oh shit, I threw a grenade. I just gave my position away. Accidentally threw a grenade. You know, recon mission. Oh shit. Oh shit. Damn. Only got what? Any suppressed rounds left? Oh shit. Brain just exploded. How sick was that? No. Right here in the cut. Damn. Climb a fence. Poor game design. Not even more than climb a fence. Alright, so we're all clean around here. Leaving your man exposed. Good. This one. Damn. Alright, there's something in this place, because it's just surrounded. So what's in here? Oh shit. Oh, I killed the officer with the trip mine. That's dope. Oh shit. Get up.
All right. No more to find here.
Wait, what? Do what? Booby trap body with trip mine. That's dope. Kill Schmidt. You know what? I'm gonna kill him, then we'll call it. God damn it. Shit, I did not mean to do that. binoculars. Damn, right in his heart. Stabbed you? Oh, shit. Then I die. Mother. Come on, dog. All right. I'm gonna call it a night right there. Share button. Just that broadcast sentence.